You've been lied to. When you get cut, you're told to throw on rubbing alcohol, let it dry out, praise the scab. And that's completely wrong. If you did the exact opposite and kept it moist so a scab doesn't form, your cuts would heal twice as fast with less pain and scarring. But there's one big problem. With no scab, your cuts are an open door to dirt and bacteria.
Ugh.
So, to shut them out, we had to invent these. Advanced dressings, and they can be made from seaweed, from acrylic. But these here, that use the advanced healing powers of Jello, make healing so much easier and better for us. But nobody here seems to know they exist. That's totally different though, in Japan.
Kizu Power Pad は守って治す二層構造。防水密着フィルムが傷を守り、医療用治癒ポリマーが傷を治します。だから、貼る。
Back in the 90s, Bandaid made their Kizu Power Pad brand a household name in Japan. And moist healing became a topic that regular people would talk about. But here in North America, we're still drying things out and slinging cotton like it's 1860s with these crappy fabric bandages that let in water and bacteria. But I guess air can get inside, so it's okay. It's not okay. You can do better. And once you understand moist healing and Jello bandages, scabs will seem disgusting. Cotton will feel like trash, and rubbing alcohol, just barbaric. Quick note, I'm not a doctor, just a curious biology major who went way too deep into the science of wound care. This video is for informational purposes only. Consult a medical professional if you have concerns. Let's get into it.
BetterHelp is the paid partner for this video. More of them later.
Most big breakthroughs start by challenging assumptions. Maybe the Earth revolves around the sun. Can humans fly? And in 1962, Dr. Winters asked, what would happen if we kept a wound moist? So he took a few pigs and made a few shallow cuts on their skin. Some he then sealed under plastic wrap, and the rest he left open the scab. He waited. The results changed everything. Winters showed that wounds kept moist healed twice as fast as those exposed to air. And since then, thousands of other studies have shown that for cuts, scrapes, and burns, a moist environment speeds up healing. Let me show you. Here's one paper that's visual but not disgusting. Similar to the pig experiment, researchers created a few circular wounds on humans and applied this exact ointment to some, and others they let dry out. Here's the results over 12 days, and it's clear the ointment healed way faster than the one that was left to dry out and scab. Moist is clearly better. Stunning. And it was also paid for by Beiserdorf, the manufacturers, so they can slap on a marketing claim that it heals 2 times faster. Isn't science and business fun? But don't worry, this isn't a ploy by big ointment to get your money. To understand why moist healing works, let's see how a scab slows everything down. Check this out. Two cross sections of burned skin. The dotted section shows how much tissue died, and it's far deeper when you dry out your skin as your cells need moisture to survive. You're paying a pound of flesh to the biological mafia for protection.
I'm gonna make him an offer he can't refuse.
The deal keeps getting worse as a scab becomes a giant blockade that forces new skin cells to tunnel under your scab, as there's only a small moist space they can survive. Healing slows way down. But what if a scab never forms? Let's go. Cells can zoom across as there's nothing getting in the way. There's also more exudate, which is a nutritious fluid your body produces, and there are tons of benefits. For example, like calming and soothing your nerve endings, which reduces the itchy feelings or pain you get as you're healing. Exudate is super important. It's a vehicle that brings proteins, immune cells in, and allows dead tissue to be quickly removed. Exudate is the key to healing faster, and it's also a huge problem. To understand why that matters, let's talk about the cover Dr. Winters first used back in 1962. So for something flexible and waterproof, All he had was saran wrap, and I'm going to cover myself on the hottest day of the year to prove a point. If I looked under my skin, it is completely sweaty underneath here. There's tons of water, and if I just left this underneath, I would look like I've been in a bathtub for hours, just all wrinkly. And the problem with that is my skin would break down and it could get infected. This is called maceration, when the skin around your wound gets too wet too long. Not good. It's also why over decades, we invented so many different technologies because we need to be Goldilocks with moist healing. Not too wet, not too dry, somewhere in the middle. And each product handles different types of situations. Like take these foam dressings. They're like wound diapers and they'll pull exudate and bacteria away from your skin into the upper layers. Great if you're healing pressure ulcers, but they're too aggressive for small cuts. Like they'll suck the moisture right out and you're back to scabbing. So for us regular people with our basic burns, cuts and scrapes, there's one technology that's perfect. Hydrocolloid. Let me explain. Okay, let's start with the traditional fabric bandage. Sticky edges, cotton pad that soaks up blood. But hydrocolloid, it looks the same all the way across, and the entire bandage is sticky. What's going on? The magic is it blends an adhesive and Jello together to absorb fluids. Okay, not literal Jello, but its active ingredient, gelatin, and hydrocolloid bandages are packed with it. You've probably seen how gelatin works. Take some hot water, add Jello powder, stir, chill, boom, and out comes a delicious wobbly dessert. Here's what's happening. Gelatin is a protein, and in hot water, it floats around aimlessly. When cooled, they can link together and form a gel matrix. Think of it as a prison that holds a ton of water. This is how 7 grams of solid gelatin can hold 500 milliliters of liquid. It's kind of amazing, and the end result is what's called a colloid. And when you touch it, it's not soaking wet, just slightly moist. And that makes this the perfect moisture level to heal our cuts and scrapes. This is the super bandage you want. A week ago, I got cut, and the experience was weirdly fabulous. It goes on easy, and within a few hours, that white bump is the Jello being formed, and by day 4, a nice squishy dome that protects against knocks and bumps. Gelatin can hold 20 times its weight in water, but notice how it's concentrated in the cut area versus a regular bandage, so it doesn't dry out or moisturize areas it shouldn't. When I want to remove it on day 5, there's no wrinkly skin, and because the entire thing is waterproof, it made it easy to shower and play sports. Hydrocolloid technology is incredible, but healing isn't just about the body. It's also about the mind. And that's what led me to explore therapy more seriously with BetterHelp, the paid partner for today's video. Like many of you, I care about my mental health. I've listened to hours of Esther Perel and Brené Brown, read tons of books, taken multi-week workshops to better connect to other people. I have tools, and yet I still struggle because I'm human. When I'm feeling low, talking with my high EQ friends have helped me to reframe my thoughts more positively. And one of my favorite quotes is, "Don't believe everything you think." Those same friends would also tell me, "You should really try therapy." But I put it off. Researching, phone calls, asking for availability, it's all a lot of work, and I get analysis paralysis. This is where BetterHelp comes in. They're on a mission to remove friction and make starting therapy easier. You fill out a short questionnaire and they match you with a credentialed therapist as soon as possible. You get a short description and you can look them up and see if they might be a good fit for you. The whole point of therapy is to find someone who listens, understands, and guides you through your own thoughts and struggles. If your therapist isn't a good fit, with BetterHelp, you can switch easily. For me, this finally felt doable, so I'm starting my session soon. And if you've been putting this off like I have, maybe now's a good time to try. You can head to betterhelp.com/AndrewLamb or click the link in the description to get 10% off your first month of therapy. Okay, let's get back to our story. And before we put on our fancy new bandages. We need to stop bacteria and toss some medieval nonsense into the trash bin. So let me first hit you up with a mystery. Ever heard of anal fissures? That's when you, and a cut opens up. Ouch. But despite poop, these cuts rarely get infected. Why? To help answer that, we need to rethink what causes infection, starting with why tap water might be better than rubbing alcohol at cleaning your cuts and scrapes. Now, just like a zombie movie, wounds get infected when there's too many bacteria and your body can't fight it. So when you get cut, out comes the rubbing alcohol and hydrogen peroxide. Die, bacteria! Feels like victory, but here's the truth. Alcohol kills bacteria, but also your flesh. It's like finding mice in your garage and burning that bitch down. Do you know what they use in emergency rooms to clean wounds? Saline. Sterile salt water. And I got a bottle here, and... well, that's a dollar. It's expensive, and it might not even be necessary. Check out this review from Wounds UK. Tap water of drinkable quality is safe and effective for the cleansing of fresh wounds. Though, you can turn on your faucet and rinse your cuts and scrapes. But wait, Andrew, water doesn't kill bacteria. Right, it doesn't have to. And here's the magic mind shift. Imagine this mustard is bacteria, and you go and turn on the tap. You're not destroying bacteria, you're rinsing it away, like poop down the toilet. The water carries bacteria off your skin before it has a chance to dig in. Now, infections can still happen. Maybe your immune system sucks. Maybe you won the crap lottery and you got flesh-eating bacteria. But for healthy people, infections often come from one thing: structure. Can bacteria build an Al-Qaeda bunker? Yep, that's a wild metaphor, but roll with me. What gets infected more, dog bites or cat bites? If you said dogs, you're wrong. Dog bites get infected around 18% of the time. Cat bites, 4 times more. Here's why. Dog teeth make bigger wounds, but they're wider, so the wound stays open. It's easier for bacteria to be flushed out. But cats, little vampires, thin fangs that stab deep, inject bacteria, and then the skin seals right up, trapping everything inside. Those bacteria are warm and safe and start building biofilms, jelly shields that block your immune system from getting in, and then they can multiply and release toxins. You get an infection. That's when you need antibiotics, and sometimes even drainage. One Japanese surgeon uses twisted nylon thread to keep bite wounds open, giving your body time to flush the bacteria out. Also, remember Bin Laden hiding in the caves of Afghanistan? They tried airstrikes, but he was safe, and once the Americans left, him and Al-Qaeda could go out and wreak havoc. That's what bacteria do, and wound care experts know how to identify and bust open these bunkers. It's why dirt is scrubbed out, dead tissue dissolved with enzymes, or cut away with scalpels. And fun fact, scabs are bunkers too. That's one reason moist healing has lower infection rates. Now, to circle back to earlier, why are most anal fissures not infected? Because most are surface level, no bunkers. And yes, there are other reasons too, but this explains why tap water can often be enough, but not always. Go see a medical professional if you have concerns, please. And stuff just appears because I couldn't figure out a great transition to part 4. We need to upgrade your first aid kit because this isn't just about busting myths on scabs and alcohol. I want you to actually heal faster. And after tons of testing, I've narrowed it down to 3 picks that actually work. Let's start with my top choice. Bandaids, HydroSeal all-purpose hydrocolloid bandages. And these things are game changers. They're waterproof and sticky, so you can shower and chop meat, and they'll stay put and clean, unlike fabric that instantly gets soaked and gross. Plus, they're shaped better. The taper edges make them wrap comfortably around tricky spots like knuckles. It's like the leather jacket of bandages, soft, flexible, broken in just right. Also, if you're like me, you tend to have 2 types of injuries, either a long cut or a small gouge. On most hydrocolloid bandages, the gooey healing layer is just a little dot in the middle. But on these, it runs the full length, so you're better covered for injuries. I love them, and I think you'll love them too. Oh, and if you ever find yourself in Japan, they sell a shiny gold version that's 25% thicker. More Jello. All right, if you fall and take a chunk out of your knee or face, here's what you want. ConvaTec DuoDERM Extra Thin. You can layer these for bigger wounds, or you can cut them to fit smaller ones. And at $2 for a 4x4 sheet, these are affordable. They're also a go-to pick for Dr. Natsu Makoto, a plastic surgeon who spent 20 plus years raising awareness of moist healing. On his website, he's documented over 1,000 cases, many using DuoDERM, like this man who was burned. Hydrocolloid bandages cover the majority of our home needs, but for nosebleeds or deeper cuts, I think it's smart to have calcium alginate on hand. Now, these are a seaweed-based advanced dressing that releases calcium ions to trigger clotting and stop bleeding way faster than using fabric and pressure. The name brands are BleedCease or Sorbson, but I got a generic version and it's been working pretty well for me. I get a lot of nosebleeds, so you can kind of roll this up and stick them up in there. Finally, don't use gauze directly on your wounds. Cotton is bad, and if a professional tells you to use it, their knowledge is likely outdated. So I've dropped info in the description below on how to find better wound care, extra stuff I left out like my runner-up pick, these Amazon gel bandages, and links to people and products I mentioned. Big thanks to our sponsor, BetterHelp. Mental health matters, and they make starting therapy easier. Subscribe for more. See you in the next one. Scab, your cuts are an open door. You know what else kills bacteria? Drawing things. That's one for the bloopers.